Hey again, YouTube. Thanks for stopping back by. Today, we're gonna go over a get home bag for kids. I haven't really found a lot of videos out on YouTube on this particular subject, so I figured I'd make my own and put in my 2 cents. So first off, I have a daughter. She is 6 and a half, going on 7. She's just over 4 foot tall, weighs just over 60 pounds, so she's pretty tall for her age, and this is the bag for her. This bag weighs in just under 5 pounds, so for the weight of the bag compared to her weight, it's pretty appropriate. So we're doing just some practice walks with this. We went just about a mile the other day, and she seemed to handle it pretty well. So first off, on the exterior of the bag, I always keep these shoes with it. These are just some Merrell waterproof hiking shoes. I've had them for about 1.5 years. They have held up surprisingly well. They're very comfortable. She never had any complaints on them. So just in case she's out there wearing sandals or, you know, boots or anything like that, and we need to end up walking, she can have those and hopefully be a little bit more comfortable. So this is a summertime setup for this bag, so you're not really going to see a ton of, you know, cold weather type gear. We'll change that out when the season changes, obviously. So this pouch of the bag, we just keep a little sun hat in there. This is one of the sunblock hats, so hopefully that would prevent her from getting too burned up. And the next item on the outside, and I'd recommend this for any younger kid's bag, is just some sort of a comfort item. This is her little stuffed animal named Marshmallow. We got it at the zoo. It's an Arctic fox, and she just loves it. So just some sort of a comfort item to just make them feel a little more at home, and hopefully take down the severity of whatever situation may be, so they're not feeling all that anxiety of, whatever's going on. A pair of sunglasses, a little kid's headlamp, and a couple of the individual wet ones. You guys know I love my wet ones. So my idea for this bag would just be something that we're keeping in the car, and if there was any type of car breakdown where we had to get out and walk, we would use this. You know, the worst case scenario would be some sort of a natural disaster, civil unrest, EMP type of event where nobody's out there driving, and then we can hopefully get back home and stay safe. So, but like I said, a lot of this is just going to be comfort type items. She's not, we're not going out there and living in the woods. This is just a get home bag. I hear people use get home bag and bug out bag kind of interchangeably. And for me, the get home bag serves one purpose and the bug out bag serves another purpose. So let me know what you guys think about that. Do you call your bug out bag just, is that your one and all bag that you do everything with? Or how do you break up the terms of your bags? Let me know. Next up in this top pocket, we've got easy access to some of these This Saves Lives bars for kids. She really likes these. So just a little something that she can snack on while we're out there walking. Next up is a Ben's bug head net. This would go over the top of her hat there and hopefully protect her from any mosquitoes or gnats or any flying critters that are just plain annoying. Next up is a Go Girl. I picked this up for about $10 in the camping section of Walmart. If you guys aren't familiar with this, This is what it looks like. It's just kind of a little funnel that the girl would place against her body and end up peeing out like a boy. So it's reusable. It's good for all kinds of situations. And hopefully that would just make things a little easier instead of having to pop a squat in the woods somewhere. Next up, I've got this camp towel. We got this from REI. These camp towels are very absorbent for their size, very small. It's got a cute little pattern that she likes on there. So we put that in there and it weighs just a couple ounces. Next up is a hairbrush with a couple hair ties. Couple of the chem lights in green. I've got quite a few of these in my other bags, and I've got different colors. And for me, the green ones, say they're 12 hours. From our experience, they last longer than 12 hours. The other colors that they have are 8 hours, 10 hours, but the green ones, they seem to last a lot longer. Next up in this pouch, I've just got some sunscreen, some Aquaphor. This can be used for chapped lips or any type of skin irritation, and some lotion. I have a small basic boo-boo kit in here, one little roll of gauze, and then one pack of hand warmers and one pack of toe warmers. Next up is just going to be a pack of tissues. And this is an SOL emergency blanket. Again, this is a summertime bag, but we all know summertime doesn't mean it's warm all the time. Temperatures can drop down in the, 40s or 50s even. So we don't have a big jacket. We do have a jacket, which I'll show you, but it's not a wintertime jacket. So in case it gets a little too cold for her comfort, she can cover up with this. Next up in a vacuum sealed bag so it doesn't leak anywhere, I've just got a small travel pack of the Cottonelle flushable wipes and then a travel pack of the wet wipes for general hygiene. And this is the Life Straw Play. This is designed for kids. So you unscrew this, put your water in. It's got the normal Life Straw filter here. Then they unscrew it and drink from this end. So it's a little pricey, a little more than the normal Life Straw, but it's very small and compact, and it fits great in this bag. And since she's not a full-grown adult, she doesn't drink a ton of water. This holds 10 ounces, 300 mils. We're always gonna have water in the car, so we would take a bottle of water or two, depending on the situation, and she can put those in the pockets on the outside. So that's kind of a last resort in case we need to, filter out some questionable water. So before we get to the clothes, in the water bladder section back here, I've just got a couple things to kind of keep her occupied if we do end up having to stop or, just take some time to rest. So I've got one of these play packs. It's got some crayons, a sticker sheet, and a couple of coloring pages in here. And then this is just a sticker activity book. Came in a kid's meal from Chick-fil-A. We just keep that in there and, hopefully that will keep her mind occupied and let her have, I guess, maybe a touch of fun if we're out there and in a bad situation. So I'm gonna put the bag to the side and we will go over the clothes that are in here. So it's just a full change of clothes. I've got socks and underwear. I've got some hiking pants from REI. So these are going to be great for moisture management. They're very comfortable. They don't have a, waist belt loops or anything like that. They're just the elastic up here. So hopefully those are going to be comfortable. Then I've just got a regular t-shirt. And last item, just a lightweight rain jacket from REI. You know, this can be used to keep her a little bit warm if it does get chilly. Or obviously if it rains, she can cover up with that too. So that is it for the kids get home bag. I greatly appreciate you guys sticking around and watching. Please let me know what your thoughts are on this. Does anybody have kids that you have a bag for, or do they just you know, live out of your bag? If you have a get home bag or bug out bag, let me know your thoughts on that situation. And we will see you next time. Thanks, guys.